Yeah. We're walking in.
We're here. Check out those coils.
Oh, she did so good.
Good morning and welcome back to my channel. My name is Allie and I have a blog called Grace and Lipstick. I'm gonna shoot a little vlog for you guys, and I am joining one of my best friends on her visit to the hair salon. So today I wanna share with you how the experience goes of going to a new hairstylist for the first time. And I wanna share with you a little behind the scenes from the client's perspective and also from the hairdresser's perspective, as I am a licensed professional. So if you're interested in seeing how that goes, then go ahead and keep watching. We're on our way to the hair salon, and I just want to chat a little bit on our short drive about how are you feeling about seeing a new hairstylist.
Honestly, I'm super nervous right now. I have all my confidence and faith in her, but it's one of those things, like I was explaining earlier, is I don't know if any of you can relate, but I have been going to the same person who is practically family. Shout out to Trisha. Forever, for all my whole life, and all the times I've ever gone to someone else, it's been literally a show. I
can vouch for that. I've gotten video chats of crying tears from tragic thing cuts.
It's been so bad. I cannot trust anyone, and it's gotten to the point being in San Diego and growing up in LA, I had to just take the realistic bite and find someone closer to me. Just because I don't visit home as often as I'd like to.
How did you find this girl?
So I was looking on Instagram, I was looking at Yelp, I went on Google, I even like talked to friends. The biggest thing that I really wanted is, so what kind of hair do they typically work with? Like typically you can see that just by their portfolio. And so I found Rachel through Instagram, and her portfolio was mainly brunettes. Thick hair, a good amount of like Asians actually, and I don't know if that's just coincidental. And also, like I was saying earlier, I needed a good location. And as you'll see, we are actually down the street from it right now. So, which was what, like 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Which is huge. And that's exactly what I was looking for. So just the fact that she does balayage, she does so many colors and cuts that are like within my style. She's nearby, and the price was like practically the same as I would if I drove all the way to LA. So if I'm paying the exact same thing and the same quality, and just her true honesty during our consult, it like just felt like a perfect match.
Woohoo! I'm so excited.
Yeah, so I'm excited, but I'm just like, it's those nerves of like, all right, here we go. Like,
yeah,
I'm making a change, but it's gonna be a good change.
Yeah, and it is a risk.
Yeah.
Like there is a good level of
shot.
Sorry about the lighting right now. We had a little bit of a coffee mishap in the car.
It was really funny.
Yes. And we're walking into the salon, but I quickly wanted to mention that as a professional and as her friend, when she told me about their consultation, one of the key things that stood out to me was her honesty about the process. Kristina does have very coarse hair. It's a lot of hair and it's very dark, and what she's asking for is not an easy thing to achieve for a hairdresser. So
especially one day.
Exactly. So when she was honest with Kristina and said, first of all, they're gonna be really long appointments.
Yeah.
This is my price, and I may not get you to your ultimate goal in one appointment. We may need a few. That was a really good sign as a hairdresser, because she knows what she's doing. First of all, she was able to see Kristina's hair and know that she's not gonna be able to get this ultimate
like, yeah. Inspiration photo.
Yeah, and yeah. She was like super honest and that, like, asking me the question she needed to know, like, when was the last time you got it done? You know, how does your hair hold up to the chemical? Were there any issues? Is there anything I should know about? She's like, I love this idea, but I just want to make sure it's perfect and I think it'll be good to do it in a couple sessions. So, and when I called Alice, I was like, I think this is my girl. So yeah. We're walking in.
Woohoo!
To get us some breakfast and some coffee. The salon visit seems to be going well, and I'm really excited to see how her hair comes out.
Dude, you look amazing.
Oh my god! I feel like a brand new person. She was efficient, she was friendly, and like, I even apologized because she felt bad that she wasn't talking to me as much, but she was just like, I just want to give you the best outcome, and I don't want to mess up anything because there's like color correction, cut, timeliness, foiling, just the whole process. She did not want to mess that up. So I actually really respected her just being honest.
Yeah.
And then like when she had the downtime, like she was so friendly. So overall, I am so pleased.
Just got out of an almost 8-hour salon session.
We made it. I survived. Allie survived.
It was a challenge. We're running on coffee and donuts right now.
Literally, like, it hasn't been. We haven't definitely nourished our bodies.
No. We are ready. We're ready for some nourishment.
Yeah. I'm speechless. I'm really happy with everything.
Woohoo! We have so much to talk about. I'm really excited.
Our debrief.
Yes, debriefing our day.
Yeah, literally, technically a 7-hour appointment.
Uh-huh. 7.5.
Yeah. And we did not eat a thing.
Mm-mm.
No. All right, so debrief time.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna do it mukbang style.
Yeah.
Not eating, and we are losing daylight.
I can't do this without something in my tummy.
Mm-hmm. So forgive us for the chewing.
All right, girl, ask me.
All right, so one question we had was, how do you know you're getting a good deal from the new stylist and that you're not being overcharged?
So I kind of have this is actually a really good question because I am very lucky in that my hairstylist is a family friend. And so that already in itself was kind of like, I think a hard
way for me to base off a price, because I knew like what I was getting was like based off of like family and like being close friends, but at the same time, like, I felt like it was still being, I was still being charged where like they deserve what they're worth, you know what I mean? So I took that as like an estimate and was kind of like, okay, I'm gonna add about maybe like anywhere between plus or minus 50, because like I know, well, one, I imagine, I think it's also helpful that the inside of like, okay, where am I doing it? Well, I'm in downtown San Diego. Like, I already know being in downtown San Diego, it's going to be an expensive place to rent or to have a business. So I already know part of that goes to that. And second, like, I know my hair. I know how long it takes for my hair in general. Like, I am typically a 6 to 8 hour appointment. So that I already knew in the back of my head is going to be costly. So I think just understanding exactly kind of where, what was the quality I was getting before, what was I paying, how normally long will it take to do my hair, and what are my expectations, and then kind of putting that all together. And then I did research and did comparisons, and where we did, where she was charging me, I thought was very reasonable, because it was, there were some that were kind of like half-assed jobs but cheaper, but then there were things that were very similar, high, really a lot, a huge portfolio, but like out of my budget. So I thought like that was a good way to be right in the middle.
So I completely agree, and I was actually gonna say something similar to what Kristina said. As a stylist, is doing your research in the demographic of where you're located. So definitely comparing a few different salons, a few different stylists, get a quote, have a little phone consultation. And when she sent me this girl's work just straight from portfolio and judging that, it made sense. Her prices made sense. And then as a stylist who was sitting there and just observing the entire process, she was very thorough. She was very quick. She was consistently hustling the entire time, but she was not cutting any corners, which is huge as a stylist in order to get a good result. Some stylists will cut corners because they feel the pressure to get the client out, or their pricing just isn't where it can be for it to be worth it for them to spend that much time on your hair. So if your stylist has prices that make it worth their time, they're going to put the time in and they're not going to cut any corners.
I always wondered that about, like, is there a fine line between obviously quality and like the time, but also I wonder if there are some like people out there who are like, well, I'm, this is my set price, I'm charging you by the hour, I want to get as much money as I can,
I'm going to prolong it.
Yeah. And there were times, like, being that she was my first time being like working together, like, I had moments where I couldn't help but think that, just on like how much time it was.
Is she moving as fast as she could?
Correct. And I'm used to someone who works really fast. So I really had a hard time kind of comparing when I am so used to a certain way and a certain time. And I had to think of the fact that I've never been with her before. We did a 15-20 minute consultation prior, but we've never worked together. So she had to ask me a lot of questions, like, how does your hair lift? You know, are you in pain? Do you need a break? Like, can you fight through it? Am I being too rough? You know, those were things she wasn't familiar with either. So she had to take her time, in my opinion, a little bit more, because we were both unfamiliar with one another.
Absolutely. You definitely get in a rhythm once you know your client, and once you've seen them a few times, you know what to expect, how fast their hair is going to lighten, how their hair might lighten. So there's all of those factors to take into consideration when you're seeing somebody for the first time. That was a good question. Okay, here's a good one I thought would be really interesting to hear from a client's perspective and then from a stylist perspective. What if your hair comes out differently than you expected in a bad way? Do you argue with the price or do you just pay it?
So, okay, I think from past experience, I've had really bad haircuts. When it comes to color, I think the first time I ever colored my hair was a shocking experience, but in a good way. Like, I've never done it. So I paid for it, and there was a moment where I was like, shoot, like, did I make a mistake? But like, when I compared to what I asked for, the picture, like, it was exactly what I wanted. To like translate that onto my face is kind of the mystery question of like, is it gonna work out? So I think simply the question is, like, me personally as a customer, like, I've gotten better, I think, about bringing up my needs and my wants, because at the end of the day, like, as a customer, like, I am paying, and the set price amount that we agreed to, I was like, in my head, like, okay, if I'm gonna drop hundreds of dollars on my hair, like, I want to love it and I want to like it, and I think if anything, it, in my opinion, it'll only help grow a stylist if I'm honest, you know. So in the beginning, I was really bad. I'd just pay for it. I'd kind of deal with it. But as I've gotten more and more, I think, comfortable with what exactly I want, and sometimes I don't know what that is until I am seeing the process.
Yeah.
I think I've gotten a lot better, and I think it is important to communicate that to your stylist.
So, as a stylist, I would say that if you ask for something and you don't get it, never pay and just leave and don't tell them. And especially don't pay them and leave and then pay somebody else to fix it. Being honest is always the best policy, because your stylist can, as she said, learn from what went wrong. Second, they most likely can fix it. And even if you leave and realize there's an issue, give them the opportunity to fix it before you leave them and go to somebody else, because
they might not ever know.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And they'll never learn, and they'll never know unless you're honest with them in a kind way, a caring way, an understanding way. You never want to be rude.
Right.
Unless they're rude to you. But even then, you'll look better if you're the nice one.
Yeah. And throughout my appointment, personally, she kept asking me questions like, do you like it? Do you want to change it? How do you feel about it? That, I think, was very respectful of her, because someone can be very prideful and say, I know what I'm doing. Yeah, like, I'm happy with it. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, I appreciated that she also wanted me to be happy in the end, which, you know, I assume many stylists want that. But when you are at a chair for over almost 8 hours, like, you are gonna get tired too.
Yep, 100%.
And at that point, you're kind of like, well, I'm done.
Yeah.
Like, it looks good to me.
And you're ready to run out of there.
Yeah. So I appreciated that. And if a stylist can do that, I think kudos to them. But if you also have the desire to bring that up, like, I absolutely encourage it, because you're the one that's paying and investing in your hair.
Yep, that's true. All right, last question.
Okay.
How do you know what they're capable of? Even if you just want highlights, like, how do you find the right person?
I think, personally, that kind of comes back to my research. Mm-hmm. I found, prior to who I found so many profiles where I was like, oh my gosh, like, I love their work. But then I started to notice it was the same exact work. Like, the same type of hair, the same type of cut, the same even demographic. And that's not a bad thing at all. But what I personally like to see and know is that they have diversity. They understand different types of hair. They can do different things, not just cut, not just balayage. Like, they can work with different, you know, areas.
Hair texture.
Yeah, and techniques, too. I think that's huge in my research. So, does that really say that what makes them more qualified than maybe one person's? Absolutely not. But that's something I always look for, because...
And it betters your odds.
It does, because at least I know, like, a stylist can be a one-trick pony, which is great. And if that's the exact style and you know they've mastered it, absolutely go to them. Mm-hmm. But for someone like myself who always changes it up, I don't have one look. I always like to try something new. I like to see what they're willing to do and what they have done.
I agree, and I would say the same. Doing your research, put in the work, look at Yelp, look at their Instagram, look at their comments, see if they have anything online. All of those things are so important. And also see, like she said, I think that was a huge point, was look for work on their portfolio of somebody who resembles you. Somebody who's the same ethnicity, somebody who has a similar hair color or a similar haircut, or... A lot of the times, people with super dark, naturally ethnic hair will bring in an inspiration photo of somebody who naturally has lightened hair or light hair and achieved this goal. And it's just like, you have unrealistic expectations. So finding work that you like, you know what I mean? Find inspiration from that person, photos they've done in the past. So that's the best way to kind of ensure that you have the best odds of finding a hairstylist that you're going to be happy with.
I was just going to actually add something I saved a lot of different Pinterest photos, Instagram photos of what I wanted. And then I kind of started to weed it out towards like, okay, are they Asian? In terms of, because that I will know, well, how do will I look with that hair? Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not like trying to like go against any other, you know, ethnicity or anything, but I need to know like, okay, this is this style, this color is on an Asian person. Yeah. I'm Asian.
Someone with similar skin tones, right. Texture,
and color. That's how I started to weed it out. And then I took those photos and then I took it to each of the portfolios I actually liked. And then I then compared to what they had. And it took a lot. Like, I'm not even gonna lie. Like, this schedule, this appointment has been 3 months, like, waiting. Like, I am sometimes not the most patient person, but when it comes to this and the amount of money I was willing to put into it and the work that I put into my research, like, I was willing to wait. I think from my own mistakes, and I don't know, Allie, if you can add to it, sometimes, like, the eagerness of change mm-hmm. is sometimes not the best, I don't know, the best option.
Yeah.
Because I've done things where I've gotten my hair cut the day I decided,
on a whim.
I want my hair cut today. I need change. And that definitely has slapped me in the face.
Yep. And also, if you find a stylist, they're amazing, and you're like, I am not spending that much money on them, and you choose a stylist
who you're not happy with, but you know they're
exactly, cheap. You're like, yeah, you're like, their price is way better. I'm going to them. Like, their work is going to translate. If they have good work, they're gonna have to charge the right price in mm-hmm. order to fit in clientele. Yeah. If they're that good, you know? And if you can get in with them today, chances are they're not the best on the market. There's always the mm-hmm. off day that somebody had a cancellation, they're able to fit you in, that happens. But majority of the time, you're gonna have to wait 2 to 3 months in order to get in with a stylist who is gonna be worth the money.
Would you say that's normal?
Like, yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely, I think it would be. But you also have to look out, some people just have narrow availability.
Yeah.
So they're not available for 2 to 3 months just because they work one day a week.
Right, that's true
too. So you really just gotta look out for.
I mean, the consultation really is what sold me.
Yeah.
It's one thing that I know how long I have to be in a chair with someone, and I wanna have a connection with them, and I want them to see my vision. Mm-hmm. It's one thing to please someone, but I also want them to feel that their work is going to express what I want to. So the fact that she was able to literally clearly draw me a picture, say a picture of what I'm seeing mm-hmm. was for me a match made in heaven.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
I think it was a great match. Now you have somebody local.
I do. I have someone local. I have someone at home. Like, yep. I mean, I feel set.
Yeah.
I mean, what better way
I know.
Than to know I am taken care of.
I agree. 100%.
Yeah. So
that's so awesome. I'm so happy.
I'm so happy that you guys joined me on this journey.
Yes.
Thank you for documenting this. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait to see all your feedback. And I hope you guys enjoyed it too.
Yes. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and feel a little bit more confident when it comes to finding a new hairdresser or visiting a hairdresser for the first time. I want to extend a huge thank you to my friend Kristina for being in this video with me and sharing her experience. She really had some great advice, and she was successful at trying out a new hairstylist for the first time, so it was the perfect person to do this vlog with. And I also want to thank her stylist, Rachel, for being cool with us, getting a few shots of her work here and there. And yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a little thumbs up. It really helps my channel grow. And if you would like to see more videos from Grayson Lipstick, then make sure you subscribe. All right, have a nice day. Bye.
Today I'm going to take the... I can't actually drink it.
It's hard.
That was all for...
And then it was dumb because I was like trying to close my eyes at the same time.
There is a good level of...
Shut!
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I don't think it got wet.
It looked like a spicy oak.
Is this the entrance?
No.
I think it's okay. No, sorry. As excuse the interruption.
Thanks so much for watching this video. I know that it can be super nerve-wracking and stressful finding a new hairdresser,